He that says he is in light and hates his brother is in darkness. He that loves his brother abides in the light, but he that hates his brother is in darkness and walks in darkness and knows not where he goes, because the darkness has blinded his eyes.
Amen.
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 Yes.
James Chaney, I come all the way from Meridian tonight. I'd like to give these to some of your folks inside here, if I could just have some time maybe to talk.
Son, you can't come barging in here now.
Sir, would you mind circulating some of these for me after the service is over?
I can't see where they're any of the Lord's business.
Can I come back another time?
Temperance League meeting goes on Friday. We have a funeral Saturday. We're closed on Monday.
How about Wednesday?
Y'all come back another time when we're not busy. Be careful going home now. You hear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Junior, in the house now.
Come on. I'll call Mama from the center.
As our illustrious governor is reported to have said, this is not the United States of America, this is Mississippi. I guess he means you can't have law and order and Negroes too. Last week, a brother was arrested in Jackson for reckless walking.
The point that Dave is making is that we are being picked off one by one by one. There are not enough of us to do this job.
Right.
That is why we need their help.
Dave, with all respect, I got a hard time picturing some clean jean, white Harvard boy getting down and dirty in the cotton fields with us colored folks.
Once he sets foot in those cotton fields, he'll be on intimate terms with the issues
why
soon
is
enough.
Every time we got a problem, we got to go to the white man to fix it for us. I don't trust the crackers.
James, because he's part of the problem, he is a part of the solution.
This has to turn into a national issue.
The white folks in here! The white folks in here! The white folks in here!
We don't have all
the white folks in here! The white folks in here! The white folks in here!
Hi. I'm Mickey Schwerner. This is my wife, Rita.
Hello.
Welcome. Mickey, drop your stuff. Mickey, Rita. I'm Dave Dennis. Dave. This is Matt Suarez and Sue Brown, who run things around here. Why don't you take a seat?
Matt?
Hi. Hey.
How you doing?
Everybody, I'd like to introduce you to our volunteers from New York City, Mickey Schwerner and his wife, Rita Schwerner, who were chosen out of several hundred applicants to help supervise our voter registration drive here in Meridian. Matt will train them in order to pave the way for the 1,000 others that will be coming in June for Freedom Summer. We'll start by continuing to push our voter registration drive, talk to people, help them get out to the polls. Once Freedom Summer starts, we'll have a lot more help and maybe things will change.
Okay.
Do as much as you can. Be patient. Remember, you're up against an attitude that's taken 350 years to build.
Rest easy. We're here for as long as it takes.
Glad to hear that. All the same, I'll be calling you from Jackson every week to check in on you. If you got any questions, you can talk to Matt.
You call me when you get in. Let me introduce you to your assistant, Mr. James Chaney. Take good care of him.
Hey, James. How you doing? What's your name?
Ben.
Hey, Ben, I'm Mickey. So, we're just parked over here.
Oh, Mickey, look, they've slashed our tires.
What?
Oh, God.
Oh, jeez. Well, we've been here an hour and a half.
We ain't seen nothing. This here, just a hello kiss. And I get rid of them New York plates I was you, and that goatee.
morning.
Hey, Ben.
Who are you?
My name's Mickey. This is my wife, Rita.
We're working with James.
What's going on, Ben? What's that? Oh, God. James!
Morning.
James Earl Chaney! You've gone straight out of your head, boy. What are those white folks doing in my living room?
Mama, I couldn't find no place else for them to stay. Nobody else would take them. They're leaving right now. Come on, y'all.
This movement ain't nothing but trouble.
Just get your stuff.
Now get on back to your bedroom. Go on.
Yeah. Oh, hey, look what we got coming down the street here.
Follow me.
Just ask
the
phone.
Make a scene.
How you doing?
You going away from me now. Gone.
Where you think you're going?
To the tire store. Can you believe it, Chief? We got two flat tires. You guys got some rough roads down here.
See, this ain't the way to the tire store. See that boy there? Now he knows the way to the tire store.
Come on, Mickey.
I'm here to tell you, two boys, get off the street.
Come on, let's go.
When you talk to us, you say, sir. You hear me, boy?
Okay. Okay, I'll call you, sir, if you call me Mr. Jew Boy.
Jew Boy. Here's your bus ticket.
Hey!
James!
Where the hell did you think you was going?
Exercising passive resistance.
James. That there was passive stupidity. You don't think I wanted to tell him to get the hell out of my way?
Boy, I don't know about where you come from. But down here, when a colored man stands up to a white man like that, it ends one way. With him swinging from a tree.
James, I don't think every confrontation has to start with screw you and end up with somebody getting killed.
Look here. You want to play Russian roulette? You point the gun to your own head. Not at me and not at my little brother. You understand? Come on.
Way out of schedule, honey. 2 days in town, and we've only made 6 known enemies.
Not including James.
Well, obviously, they're gonna be Negroes who aren't gonna trust us, and if I was them, I'd probably feel the same way.
Come here. Look at that.
We are a long way from Washington Square. Oh, man, this place needs so much work. I think if I made some new curtains, it would cheer things up a bit and wash the walls. So, we need a bucket, we need a mop, we need dishes, pots, and pans. Oh, I got this idea. I want to start a library at the center, so I thought if I wrote publishers asking for book donations,
yeah,
and I could get a projector, we could show films. What? What? I think it's very important that the kids have a place they'll want to hang out in.
I love it when you get that passionate activist look in your eyes.
You need a typewriter, too.
Hey.
What?
We're okay.
You love it down here, don't you?
Welcome home.
Candles! We need candles!
Head over there, back me on the other one, okay?
All right.
You certainly in some kind of mood today. Who put starch in your shorts?
The Emancipator.
Our Ava leader.
Came here because it was a place where we could help ourselves, Sue.
Look, why don't you just go on out that door and try and register some votes?
Well, that's just what I need. More fresh air from the doors being slammed in our face. Sometimes I feel like all we're doing is just watching the paint peel off the walls.
As I recall, that's what you said the day after you got here. And the day after that. And the day after that.
Hi, my name's Mickey Schwerner, and I'm working on a voter registration.
just a closer walk with thee.
When you registers the votes, they print your name in the newspaper. What you think gonna happen when the Klan reads my name?
And unless you do, nothing's gonna change. So won't you come down to the courthouse to register to vote?
We are too old to get into bed. When we die, we'll be free.
Thanks for your time.
Last time I was down there, to register, she asked me how many bubbles there is in a bar of soap. I told her there's just as many bubbles in a bar of soap as there is drops of water in the sea. Reckon I must have missed it by a few, because she done flunked me.
Listen, you got to try again, Mr. Watkins. We'll be there this time to make sure that that doesn't happen.
Is that so?
You know, up north where I come from, they don't know what it's like down here. They think you don't want to vote.
I'll be there.
Great. Great, Mr. Watkins. Now, the courthouse opens at 9 a.m. We'll come by around 8:30 to pick you up.
No need.
We'd be glad to give you a ride.
Said I'll be there.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, sir. We'll see you at 9 a.m. All right, James. Tough day. But once we get Mr. Watkins registered and word spread, we are gonna score.
Dreamish, Schwerner. He ain't gonna show.
What are you talking about?
You're just yesing you to get rid of us.
I think the man wants to vote.
Hey, Mickey, just like you just now said, a whole lot of people don't know what it's really like down here. Of course, now, you've been down here a whole 5 days now, so...
You writing a book, James?
You slick, Mickey. But I know you're kind. You won't go back up to New York and tell everybody how you came down and showed the poor color folks how to be white.
Just like you. All right. All right, whatever you think. But I came down here to help.
Well, praise the Lord.
And praise my Uncle Zeke, who told me, beware a Greek fan gift, colored men asking for loans, and a white man that wants to help the nigger.
Man, that is a load of crap. Look, you may have been with the center long before I got here, but I gotta wonder where you're really at.
Well, damn it, Mickey, we'll see where you at when the man's chasing you down a dark road some night.
Question number 7. By what name do you wish to be called if someone else in the precinct should have your same name? Hollis Gabriel Watkins. Question number 9. How long is the Mississippi River? And how many counties does it run through? Question 17. You will now interpret in full and to my complete satisfaction paragraph 183 of the Mississippi State Constitution. You have 5 minutes. Take your time.
That's all right, Mr. Watkins. We can go now.
Miss Flowers, thanks for your time.
Well, you're most welcome.
Can I ask you one question, ma'am?
By all means.
Well, as a visitor from out of state, I'm trying to learn about Southern traditions, and I'd be eternally grateful if you could explain to me paragraph 183 of the Mississippi State Constitution.
Where are you from, and what is your name, sir?
Mickey Schwerner, ma'am, from New York City.
Well, Mickey, why don't you stay home and clean up New York? You've got it a lot worse up there. Good day now.
Good day.
See you again, James.
Don't you worry, Mr. Watkins. We'll figure out a way around this.
Thanks for coming, sir.
Thanks for coming, sir. Now you see, even if we get folks down here, there's one test for y'all and another for us.
But we can get past that. Listen, with the Freedom Summer volunteers coming down here, we'll have the manpower for study programs. We can have them lined up around the block trying to register. And we can petition the courts to throw out these crooked tests. We can do it, James.
Lord D, Mickey. I sure can't imagine why none of us ain't never thought about that before. We could have solved this mess a long time ago.
Why are you so damn cynical? I'm not your enemy. I'm on your side.
Nah, Mickey, you're not the enemy. You're like a pinch hitter. Gonna play one big league bull crap inning. Man, I've been down to this courthouse 100 times. You study the test and they just keep changing the questions. See, when you get tired, the way I get tired of trying to outsmart Miss Flowers, you gonna carry your lily white ass on back to Brooklyn or anywhere else you damn well please. But I'll still be there in that waiting room, waiting.
So what's your solution?
How about burn this courthouse down?
That's a good way to spend the rest of your life, making license plates.
What you gonna do? What you gonna do when somebody hits you upside your head with an axe handle? Just smack them back with some philosophy?
No, man. I'm not gonna smack them back at all. If they gotta hit me upside the head, then that's their need, and I understand that. But my need is to try to help.
On. How many do you think it's going to take for the electricity?
I don't care if they turn it all off. We're not leaving.
Oh, God. No. You know what I could go for right now?
What?
A Sabrette's hot dog.
Oh!
And an egg cream.
Oh, ah! Oh. I would trade 4 egg creams and 2 Sabrette's hot dogs for 1 hot pastrami sandwich.
Oh, God, with mustard.
Oh,
stop.
Actually, you know what I'd settle for at this point? I'd settle for just one person being nice to me, just one person smiling at me.
Yeah. You know what I miss the most? Pigeons.
Pigeons?
I do. I miss pigeons. They're little dirty feet tap dancing on the windowsill.
I'm not married to a pigeon lover. I'm not.
The life of that nigger-loving Jew that almost got run over today, well, that was just a warning to get your sorry butt out of town.
Another one.
Mickey, did someone try and run you over today? Mickey?
Muffin. Oh, Muffin.
Just tell me what happened.
Just some jerks trying to scare us.
The woman looked extraordinary. Grandma, what great arms you have. That is the hug you better, my dear. Henry, what great
eyes.
That is the better to see, my dear.
I think these men are looking for you, James.
Hmm? You the fella come out to Mount Zion Church a while back, put these notices on our cars.
In Shelby County?
Yeah. Folks out our way interested in hearing what you got to say. I'm Charlie Parham.
I'm Emmett White.
And we want to register to vote.
It's all right. Well, you gentlemen have certainly come to the right place. Hey, everybody, listen up. This is Charlie and Emmett who want to vote.
Jake, hold on!
I said you ain't coming.
I'm coming.
No, you ain't.
You think I came down here to answer telephones and run a mimeograph machine?
You want to help out so much, Mickey Schwerner, stay here.
No way, man.
The rednecks here in Meridian mostly like to scare you. If we go out there together in the same car, white and colored, in the Shelby County, man, it'd be happy hour for the Klan.
Don't you see, man?
Your passive stupidity be a real big hit there.
Then you gotta take me, man. I gotta go where I'm a big hit.
You got no idea how easy it is to just disappear around here. Forever.
Right. Like Invasion of the Body Snatchers.
It ain't a joke.
I know. Let's go.
Get in the back.
Why?
Because in case we do get pulled over, at least you can act like I'm your driver.
Okay. That makes it feel more comfortable. Well, onward, James.
I swear you're the most uppity white man I've ever met.
Man ain't nothing but a slave if he don't try to vote.
That's right.
And it ain't no use saying you ain't in a mess. Because if you're born in the Shelby County, Mississippi, you're born dead in the mess. These folks come out here to help us tonight. They risked their lives for us. I want you all to listen to him. Come on up here, James.
I'm James Chaney from over to Meridian. We came here to help you folks register to vote. Which one?
I'm Mickey Schwerner. I'm from up north. How many of you here want to register to vote? All right.
Now, how many of y'all know how to read and write? What's the hunk you got to do with all this?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Mickey here has been to college. That's why he came. Mickey's gonna teach all y'all how to read and write. Ain't that so, Mickey?
I'm gonna try.
How y'all gonna do all that?
We're gonna have schools. Freedom schools. We're hoping to have one right here in Neshoba. Ain't that right, James?
We'd like to have it at Mount Zion Church if y'all have us. Then y'all will know what you need to know so you can pull those levers.
College students will be coming down here this summer to help teach in these schools.
Oh, Reverend Jenkins preaches that there ain't no room in the church for agitation.
That's right. Don't care about voting. I don't need no vote. I need a job.
That's right. We hear you. And we're going to do something about that, too. We're organizing boycotts of the stores around here. It'll sell you their goods, but won't give you their jobs.
Then you gotta tell Reverend Jenkins that you don't see how Jesus can be in a church that ain't for freedom.
Now, maybe you can't vote in Neshoba yet, but you should be able to vote in your own church about whether or not to have the school.
What kind of church do you come from?
I'm Jewish.
Oh, no. Jewish.
You know, my people aren't all that different from yours. And we've learned from history how important it is to stand up for your rights. They're saying in Jackson that now is the time for white men to stand up like men and say to you, never. What we're saying is that now is the time for you to stand up and say to them, now.
See, brothers, all you got to do is just meet us halfway. Take that to Reverend Jenkins, and we'll take it on to the next step.
Boys are telling the truth. But we got to put this to a vote.
You want this school. You got to stand up and be counted. Now, who wants it?
Sign yet?
No.
Hey, when Reverend Jenkins hears what's been happening, he's gonna think he's been hoodooed.
I tell you what, when all them folks stood up, that was something else.
Yeah, we did good.
Amen. I just hope your college buddies are for real if this freedom school thing's gonna work out.
Well, if they're not, you and I can teach them.
Shoot, I ain't even got a high school diploma.
Did you drop out?
Got thrown out for wearing an NAACP button to class.
They suspended you over a button?
By using your passive stupidity, I would not take it off.
James!
Why'd you come down here, Mickey?
Tell the truth, Rita and I heard about your button incident. Actually, God, a lot of things, but we heard about those little girls being killed in the Birmingham church bombing. We had to come. James.
James. Oh, man.
Made a U-turn. Following us.
Damn. I think that's Deputy Winner. Go on, Mickey. Get the hell out of here.
Relax. Can't see you. He doesn't know me from a bar of soap.
If he checks us out, it's over. I know him, Mickey. He chased me before and I hit it.
No way. Then he'll chase us for sure.
You gotta make a run for it, man.
Look, we haven't broken any laws. Don't get a rash.
This ain't no joke. Hit the pedal.
No way. Barney Fife went home. So, how many times have you done this run?
Enough to know I'm pushing my luck.
Damn, man, no time for you.
we're doing good. They've done less than half a day's normal business today, and this is just the beginning.
Ah, hey, you race next to nigger loving fatty.
A better day is a better job for one Negro than two, and we can make the difference. We can make the difference. Y'all can make the difference. I'll stay out of this store until Mr. Barrett realizes that he needs us as much as we need him.
Absolutely.
Come on here.
We take care of our own nigga. You Yankees going home.
C.P. means niggers, apes, alligators, kids, and hogs.
That's it. Good. Remember what we talked about.
Don't do it. Don't fight back. No violence.
Schwerner.
Ma'am. I was born and raised in Mississippi, and I'm ashamed of a lot of the things I've been seeing and hearing lately. So I know why y'all have come down here. But as anxious as you are to change things, it's not going to happen overnight. You know what causes a hard-working, God-fearing family man to turn into a hog-crazy Klansman with a sheet over his head running around in the middle of the night setting fire to churches? Well, it's the fear that outsiders will take away his job, his way of life, and what little self-respect he has left, and give it to the Negro. Now, a long time ago, this society built a wall around itself.
We understand that, Your Honor. What we're trying...
But what you don't seem to understand is that that wall can't be demolished all at once without damage to the people on both sides of it.
Then how do you suggest we go about changing things, sir?
Well, miss, if I knew the answer to that, I'd be looking at the statue of myself out there on the town square, wouldn't I? Well, being as I don't, I can only urge you to be real cautious.
Well, it's easy for us to be real cautious because we have our freedom. It's just not so easy for those who don't.
Well, you've seen what happens when you push too hard too soon.
Oh God, our heavenly God, as finite creatures of time and dependent creatures of thee, we acknowledge thee as our sovereign Lord. Permit freedom and the joys thereof to forever reign throughout our land. Give us the strength to prevent the mongrelization and the destruction of our state, our families, and our loved ones by the nigger communist invaders beset upon us. Support us
in the elimination of the white Jew mixers and all collaborators of the enemy forces so that we may be victorious.
All rise. Bless us now that we may honor thee in all things. We pray in the name of Christ, our blessed Savior. Amen.
Sweetheart.
Will you please get out of my way?
Ooh.
Touchy, ain't she?
Oh, must be at time of month.
I bet she ain't getting any at home.
Is this your idea of a good time? Harassing women in laundry?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, it is. What are these panties at you, girl? Huh? Huh? You know, you mix me. You think you own
the world. Don't get hands off me.
We'll do whatever we want. I bet she'd talk a lot nicer if we was niggers. Well, we all know why her and her husband came down here.
Come here, boy.
Sleep with niggers.
Stop it! Stop it! Get your hands off!
Just what do you boys think you're doing? Just get out of here! Touching me! Do you understand? They were touching me, Mickey. They had their hands all over me.
Look. From here on in, I won't leave you alone. Don't do this.
They're all sick bastards. We're not going to change anything.
That's not true. We've made progress.
Look, I don't know how I made a landmine of you. You have to stay, I understand, but I just can't take it.
Look, I can't do it without you. We've got to keep it together.
Until when? What's going to happen next? I mean, you're going to wake up tomorrow morning and think everything's hunky-dory. You will. I know you. I know you so well. Well, I don't know how you keep blocking these things out.
All right! All right! Forget the summer project. Forget the voter registration drive. The hell with the Freedom School. The only good nigger is a stupid nigger. And what the hell do you teach them to read for? They should be on the cotton fields where they belong. I don't know. Maybe James is right. Maybe we should just burn the whole damn rotten town. I don't know anymore.
I don't either.
God, Rita. This is not at all the way I thought it would be.
If you knew, you would have come anyway.
Thank you.
Somebody's up there.
Mickey. You don't look too good.
Hey, Mickey, you okay?
Mickey, we came straight from our church meeting to give you the news. The congregation then voted to have us to Freedom School.
That's right. We got it, Mickey.
That's just great, Charlie. Yeah.
That the law is upheld.
Yeah, well, remember, it's come your re-election.
Yeah, and I'm going to remember it next time you're hauled in front of my court for being drunk, too.
Hey, you nigger, I'm a hanger!
We're here to see that Mr. Watkins gets a fair chance to register this time. By the way, I think you know Judge Allred.
How's the garden club, Ida? You got that hybrid daylily yet?
Well, yes, I did, Judge. Thank you. By gosh, we tried to register up poor Mr. Watkins, but he flunked the test 3 times. It's all a matter of record if you'd like to see it. I honestly don't understand why you keep coming back taking that test over and over again, Mr. Watkins.
So that I can vote people out of office like you, Mrs. Flowers.
All right.
Section 60 of the Mississippi State Constitution. No bill shall be so amended in its passage through either house as to change its original purpose, and no law shall be passed except by bill, but orders, votes, and resolutions of both houses.
That is correct.
Congratulations, Mr. Watson.
So great, congratulations. It's really
good. All right, James!
Ha 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 ha!
Hey, what's your name, boy? I'm Andy Goodman, sir. What you smiling for, nigger lover? Don't you know I just as soon kill you as look at you? Huh? What's the matter, Jew boy? Or is it mama's boy? Come on, you little commie faggot, Jew boy! I bet you're peeing your pants!
Screw you!
Sorry. I blew it.
It's okay. Got carried away. But this is no joke.
Almost too real, but this is what it's gonna be like in Mississippi, and you cannot afford to get carried away there. Let's take a little break. Very good.
Mind if I join you?
Hey, Nick, sit down. Hey, Reverend. What's the matter?
You tell me.
Hey, Mickey, they just didn't know who you were.
Great. Next time I'll flash on my battle scars. I don't get it. Are we doing all of this so that you can all still sit on one side of the room and we can sit on the other?
Maybe things up north are not that different after all.
It's not good enough, James.
But then again, at least up here, I got a choice. I can choose to sit down next to your ugly face if I want to.
In Jackson, Mississippi today, Mayor Alan Thompson unveiled this 13,000-pound armored tank with steel walls and bulletproof windows in preparation for what he called the onslaught of communist-oriented goons, referring to the Freedom Summer volunteers due to arrive here any day now. On a related front, FBI Director J. Edgar Hoover made this statement.
We most certainly do not and will not give protection to civil rights workers. In the first place, the FBI is not a police organization, purely an investigative organization, and the protection of individual citizens, either natives of the state or coming into the state, is a matter for the local authorities. The FBI will not participate in any such protection.
What we are attempting to do here involves tremendous risk. No privileged group has ever given up anything without a struggle. All of you should be scared. If you can't deal with it, we'll respect you just the same for dropping out. And so I ask you, if for any reason you are hesitant about what you're getting into, please, it's better if you leave now. As for the rest of you staying on, you'll have to depend on each other. There is no turning back. Thank you.
Hello again. Hey, I talked to your wife. I found out we got some things in common.
Yep.
Yeah. I went to school at Walden, too.
Really?
I was 3 years behind you.
Don't tell me. You were at the March on Washington, and you did a term paper on Martin Luther King.
Close.
Malcolm X. More advanced than I thought.
Hey, listen. I'm supposed to go to Canton, but I asked for a transfer to Meridian. I'd really like to work with you.
What was your name again?
Andy Goodman.
Okay. Andy, you heard what Bob Moses said.
Yeah.
And my advice to you is to find someplace else. Someplace safe.
Hey, wait! I came to Ohio because I really... Look, I don't want to get all political with you. But if I wanted safe, I'd be backpacking through Europe right now.
Hey, it's not too late.
Hey, Schwerner, why do you have it in for me?
It's got nothing to do with you.
Look at him. Gone, boy. I see you got to go off campus to find a pool hall around here. Look here, you want to play some eight ball?
Notice my concentration. Rule number one in pool. If you're going to make your shot, don't look up.
Yeah, I guess rule number two be hit something.
You see, if you let yourself think about what you're doing, you're going to wind up behind the eight ball, wondering what happened to my great stroke. Realizing, dummy, you looked up.
Mickey, what the hell are you talking about?
I looked up, James. When I first came down to Mississippi, it was all so clear and simple. The whole South was brainwashed, and we were going to be the heroes and set everything straight. We could defy him and show him something other than hate. But hate has so many things behind and in front and all around it that who the hell can tell where it's all coming from? Now we're looking down the barrels of tanks. No matter what we tell those kids, they got no idea what they're getting into.
Hey, Reverend. Hast thou lost thy faith?
I thought that we could change things without destroying people. Now I don't see how it can be avoided.
It's always been that way for us.
So what are we doing here? What? So we get a few more people past the eye to flowers of this world.
It ain't just about that.
There's over 2,000 Negroes in Neshoba County. If every one of them voted, we'd still be outvoted 10 to 1.
If it was just about the numbers, Mickey, why would Whitey go so far that he'd even try to kill us to stop it? It's the power of the idea. It ain't nothing more powerful than that.
I don't know, James.
Hey, Mickey. You remember when I first met you? When you and Rita fell up in that Kofo Center? Man, I used to think you was the most jive turkey I'd ever met.
But you showed me something. You really did. I'd like to believe that. Come on.
Brother, you believe that.
Get out of here.
Thank you.
There's a white boy that's been sticking around here.
White boy!
Nerd! You know damn well you lying, son of a bitch!
You don't listen to you!
Tell us you're gonna die, nerd.
I don't know!
He don't know! He don't know! Lord, have mercy! Lord, and thou forgive me! With a shell I fall!
Yeah, you better pray with me!
You boy back down here.
I would urge upon my fellow Americans that they give this bill an opportunity to take effect, that they permit the processes of law and order to govern rather than demonstrations. This bill represents an affirmation of American policy of human equality.
Well, y'all can go home now. You got your freedom.
Hey, Mickey.
The bill passed both houses of Congress today, and now only remains to be signed by the president. I'm Chris Morales, reporting live from Washington.
Sue Brown just gone. Mount Zion Church was burned down last night by the Klan. Charlie and a lot of other people beat up pretty bad.
With you.
I want you to go too, but they need you here to teach.
I shouldn't even be leaving.
I should be there with you.
Rita, not a good idea.
You and me together in a car in Neshoba County? Just asking for it. We gotta get going.
All right, I guess I can handle 5 days without you.
Does it show?
Nah, you look as cool as Sandy, what's his name, on the mound.
Koufax.
Yes.
Good. As long as James looks at my face and not at my underwear.
It's gonna get easier with all these volunteers coming down.
It's your being there for me. It makes a difference.
Go.
Okay.
Okay, take care of yourself.
I love you, baby.
What are you doing?
I heard you were leaving. And why? Couldn't just desert a fellow Walden guy now, could I?
Why not, Mickey? You can always use another good man. Okay, Goodman. Hop in.
She's a girl with a diamond ring. She knows how to shake her thing, all right. Yeah, do it right. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Tell your mama, tell your pa, I'm gonna send you back to walking somewhere.
Thank you.
J.E. Now, what you doing home?
I had to come back early and take care of some business. I'll see you later on tonight for dinner.
Well, how was Ohio?
Great. I sure didn't miss your pecan pie.
Oh, well, I'll bake you a nice fine one for dinner. James, I'm real proud of you, son.
No, I told you no. I mean no. I'm going back in the house, Ben.
Quit that long face.
Tomorrow I'll take you fishing by the creek.
All right!
All right, I'll go help Mom breakfast.
All right!
See you later, Gator.
I wouldn't go back there, Mickey.
We've got to. Charlie wouldn't have been beaten. The church would still be standing if it weren't for us.
Then there's something else you better know. The Klan went there looking for you. They want you, Mickey.
Who told those people not to be afraid? Do you think they'll ever trust us again if they know that we're hiding out here? The shades drawn and the doors barricaded?
If Dave were here, he'd never let you go.
If I don't go back there now, we've as good as surrendered. Look. I'm just going to the church. Coming right back.
Check in with me. I'll be waiting. Right there by that phone.
Sue. You're like a Jewish mother.
Guys, no way. Wrong. I spent all year in classrooms reading and hearing about this stuff. I've only got 2 months down here, and I do not intend to spend them sitting on my butt.
Let's roll.
How you doing, Charlie? I'm so sorry that this happened.
Freedom don't come cheap.
Yesterday, Emmett and me, we had a meeting here with the church elders. We agreed to rebuild the church, right up out of these ashes. We're going to hold our freedom school here yet. Even Reverend Jenkins preaching for it now.
Yes, sir. We're going to have that school.
And we're going to help you. No matter what it takes, we're gonna help you.
You best get some rest now, Charlie. And you boys ought to be leaving if you be home before dark.
Y'all be careful getting home.
We should go back the same way. Somebody could have seen us coming in on 491. They're looking for us. That's where they look.
Hey, so we'll just circle around and take 19.
Good.
peeing on cotton.
Where's all the traffic?
I don't know.
It's Father's Day. I bet a lot of people are home having supper with their families.
You sure it's Father's Day?
Yeah.
When we get back to Meridian, I gotta call my dad.
Get out! Get out!
What is it?
Definitely winner.
Where is he?
He just went by. Mickey, we need to make a run for him.
Don't do it. They catch us speeding and we're behind bars.
He ain't gonna catch me.
Maybe, maybe not.
All right.
Slow down.
All right, Mickey, that's your call now.
Get out, get out. What's happening?
It's all right. It's all right. Another lucky call. Guess it's too hot today for a coon.
Still with us, Andy?
I guess they forgot to teach us this maneuver in basic training.
Live and learn. Ouch.
Howdy, boys.
Afternoon, officer.
Y'all want to step out of the car, please? Come on, let's go. Just lay down on this side. I see some licenses, please. Well, let's see what we got here. Y'all want to turn around there? Put your hands up on top of the car, please. New York, New York, Coastal.
Can you please tell us what we're being detained for, sir?
I got the nigger here for speeding, Webb. I'm going to take these other two in as suspects on the Mount Zion church burning.
What?
Yeah. All right, boys, let's go. Go get in the car there. Come on, let's go. Get in the back seat.
I don't know.
Deputy Winter, what about our phone call? We have the right to make a phone call, sir.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Well, you in my house now, son. I guess you're just gonna have to wait.
Hey, Mickey.
Mickey?
Yeah. You know, I'll just be cool. He's gotta know there'll be people looking for us. He's just trying to shake us up, all right? I hear you.
Right about now, Sue Brown is calling everybody in Mississippi. It's just a matter of time before she's calling here.
Ma'am?
Deputy Winter will be back soon.
No, but ma'am, I was supposed to have dinner with my father. He's waiting for me in Meridian, ma'am. I told him not to worry. I'd be back before 6 o'clock. Please, ma'am. It's Father's Day. You see, ma'am,
ever since my younger brother was killed in a horrible accident. My father made me promise that we would always spend Father's Day together.
I'd let you out, but my husband got the key.
Well, then why don't you make the call for me?
Oh, he'd skin me alive.
Please, ma'am. It's Father's Day.
There's a payphone across the street. Just one call. What's the number?
He's waiting for you in the center, right?
Yeah.
What's your number? Right there in the car, ma'am.
I call the highway patrol, the jails, the hospital. They left Charlie Parham's house about 2 and haven't been seen since. Yes, I'd like to speak with John Doerr of the Justice Department. Then can you ask him to please call the Meridian, Mississippi COFO office as soon as he gets this message? It's urgent. I'll try the jails again.
No, I think we're going to be starting more than that. Are they so detailed? I think so.
Boys, I'm sorry. That old payphone's broken again. I tried.
Good try. Damn it, the deputy's been gone for hours, Mickey. This doesn't seem right to me. Something's going on. I mean, I know something's going on. Can't you tell what is going on?
Hey, calm down. Calm down. Don't jump to conclusions. James says that this kind of intimidation goes on all the time. We just gotta ride it out. And we will.
I'm sorry. You're right. I'm sorry.
It's okay. It's okay. James, I open up.
Sure could use a smoke.
Coming up.
Thanks.
Shelby County Jail. Nope. Ain't got nobody here with those names. Sure.
Yeah, look like this, you boys like your day. Judge done set your fine. Hope one of you's got $20 to pay that nigga speeding ticket.
To see how fast you boys can get out of the Shelby County. You don't make no stops. You don't make no turnoffs. You head straight out of town. Y'all got that? All right, go on, get out of here.
Jeez. I was beginning to think he was never gonna let us out of there.
Gotta find a phone booth, James.
As soon as we get the hell out of here.
I heard stories about that in Ohio, guys. But arresting us for burning up the church? I mean, that's gotta be an all-time classic.
Know it. Pull over up here. I'll call Sue.
I don't think that's a good idea. Fifteen minutes, we can kiss this county goodbye.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Till the next time.
I request a furlough, sir. A few days R&R in Miami Beach.
Denied, Goodman. R&R. You earned your stripes in the field.
That's where we need you, boy.
Yes, sir! We got a special assignment for you, Private Goodman. We want you staked out here in the Shoba by your lonesome.
You know it.
Making all underground.
Late night.
Back in the woods.
Reconnaissance missions.
Those good old boys tear you up, boy.
I didn't think I was worried you guys didn't like me.
Oh, man. When you started in about your brother...
Hey, guys, we got something coming up on us. Don't turn around now. Look, hold on. Hold on.
What the hell?
Oh, my gosh. James, there's five of them.
What's going on, man? They're all over the road. James, we're gonna get arrested for speeding.
We're already arrested for speeding, Mickey. Hold on.
Let's go, let's go, let's go!
All right, we're getting off this road.
Do it, do it. Where are you going?
I'm trying to get us out of here alive.
He knows what he's doing. Calm down. They're right behind us. Can't this thing go any faster?
Boy, calm down.
Doing good, James. Jeez.
Hold tight.
We lost him. We lost him.
Oh, Mickey, we gonna make it.
How far to the highway, James?
Not far. Should be coming right on up.
Woo! We made it!
You know y'all invited mama tonight. My girl's got barbecue ribs, collard greens, some corn on the... Mickey, we got pastrami and matzo balls for you.
Matzo.
And man, Andy, a damn pecan pie you ain't never gonna forget.
I told you boys to get out of Neshoba County.
That's what we was trying to do.
Not fast enough.
Get out of the car.
Get out of the car!
You too, boy.
Get over
there. Get up!
You have been messing in something that is none of your business. You see us going up north messing in your business, huh?
Sir, I understand how you feel. All I ask is let my friends go.
I stand with you.
James!
Hi. What gives you the right to come down here and tell us how to live our lives? Huh?
Tell us who our children got to go to school with, who I got to work with.
You ain't got much to say now, do you, Mr. Big Mouth Know-It-All? Y'all wanted to come to Mississippi. You're gonna stay here forever.
Mickey!
Huh? Mickey! Mickey!
You that other nigger-loving son of a bitch. Huh?
I am.
Oh. Ah. He didn't save us nothing but a nigger. Son?
Precious Lord, take my hand and lead me on.
Today, 44 days after their disappearance, the bodies of the three missing civil rights workers, James Chaney, Mickey Schwerner, and Andrew Goodman, were exhumed at the site of this earthen dam, 20 miles outside of Philadelphia, Mississippi, ending one of the most massive and costly manhunts in FBI history. I'm Greg Kinnear reporting from Neshoba County, Mississippi.
James Chaney lived a fuller life than many of us will ever live. He's got his freedom. But we're still fighting for ours. Mickey Schwerner's parents wanted their son buried here, next to his friend. But in the state of Mississippi, you can't bury a white man next to a colored man. There are those that don't care, and those that do, but don't have guts enough to stand up for it. And people in Washington and in other places using my freedom and my life to play politics with. I blame them as much as I blame the men that pulled the triggers and dug their graves. I know what's gonna happen. I can feel it in my heart. When they find the killers, they're gonna have a jury of their cousins, their aunts, their uncles, and I know what they're gonna say. They're gonna say, not guilty! I'm tired of going to funerals. Damn it, I'm tired. There's something else that I grieve about. Little Ben Chaney. And all the others just like him. We gotta stand up. The best way that we can remember James Chaney is to demand our rights. Go down there and register to vote. Tell the man I'm here. Give me my freedom. Freedom now. Give me my freedom now.
We shall overcome. We shall
This is James Chaney's younger brother, Ben. Ben, how do you feel now?
I feel like everybody else. But I'm ready to take my brother's place.
Are you willing to do the same work he did? Does this frighten you?
No.